international travel. This is, you know, really inspired by the fact that I love to travel internationally, but then when I finally do it, I have some frustration because I think it's, you know, it's weird being an American traveling internationally. And I think some of these jokes capture that, whether it's going through customs or just, you know, our ignorance on the metric system. You know, I didn't get to put in some of the metric system weather jokes, like when I'm in, you know, Europe and I see them do the weather and there's like all these 20s on the weather map. I'm like, I don't know what that means. You know, it's, you know, like it's the middle of summer or fall and they're like 20s on a map. I'm like, I don't know what 20 means. Like if it was zero, I would know. Anyway, and then the final joke about, you know, people being disappointed when they discover you're American. That was, I mean, that goes back to like when we did a show 15 years ago in London, and I was in a store, and a lady turned to me and asked me something, and I started talking, and she heard the American accent, and I saw her frown. And so, but we are going to continue traveling internationally, so I love it.
And also, I think that what's interesting about this joke is normally, for comedians, it's considered an enormous taboo to talk about anything to do with airlines or air travel or airports, because so many comics over the past like 40 or more years have been sitting on airplanes bored and being like, what else about this airplane? Yeah. So it's kind of looked at as a very like tread upon, you know, subject. But in this instance, this is kind of talking about like your very particular experience as like the dumb American traveler, yeah, which is kind of a persona that you've sort of developed about how we just are only in our own world. And, yeah, you know, people actually measure things differently, like weather and distances and things like that. So I think it's...
I like to think they do it wrong, but yeah.
Of course.
Okay.
And also, isn't this where the callback to the SUV bit is, kind of?
Yes, this is the callback to the SUV.
Which came later.
Which came later, because as we build the hour, there's moments when you can call back. It's, you know, it's, we've done it in all the hours, and
like, just discovering that there's something similar about the way that we, you know, sincerely as a country tried to educate the students, the children, to adopt the metric system because it seemed really easy. Yeah. And then when it didn't work, we were just like, let's go buy an SUV because it was like sort of the exact same principle.
Yeah, exactly.
As the SUV joke.